Good morning, everybody. I got a full show for you guys. I got guests Brit Garner and Darko Butorac talking about all sorts of things that are happening this weekend and next weekend here in Missoula. I got some news. I got art clips. I got events. I got Flagship Friday. I got Teen Talk. I got so much stuff. I don't know if I have enough show to show it all. So I'm going to kick things off with a little bit of weather. So let's kick it off. It's 39 degrees outside. Your high is going to be 53 degrees. Your low is going to be 33 degrees tonight. You have that 30% chance of showers. It's going to be a little wet starting off today, but it should be clearing up later tonight. Saturday for your Earth Day celebration and all your other events that are be happening outdoors and river cleanups and all sorts of stuff. I'll talk more about that a little bit later. It's going to be a high 64 degrees, and it's going to be mostly sunny that day. Saturday night, you have that 40% chance of showers. Going into Sunday, which you have about 80% of showers, but it's still going to stay fairly warm, so you have these spring showers to kind of keep you springy. As you guys get ready for all sorts of activities and stuff happening throughout your weekend. In the news, some of the things that are happening in Missoula, I just want to say that MCAT will be hosting a booth with Missoula Urban Demonstration Project this Saturday at from 3 to 7. Missoula Urban Demonstration Project is doing an event at Freecycles for celebration of Earth Day. They'll be doing a whole bunch of demonstrations, and they have a bunch of other people that will be coordinating with them as well. As MCAT will be there from 3 to 7, and we'll be doing some virtual reality, highlighting Earth Day with some Earth themed virtual reality. I think that'll be great. in a way, if you really think about it, it's more like a counter thing, because it's like, oh, you know, go into nature through virtual reality. It's going to be really sweet. But in the news, the University of Montana is buying out faculty members through retirement and early retirement at the University of Montana. Rather than get rid of some of their new programs they haven't really had a chance to launch, the University of Montana wants to go in a new direction, which includes getting rid of some of their tenured professors and an attempt to lower costs and diversify new jobs. And it does make sense if you really think about it, because if they could buy out maybe like two employees, they can create maybe three or four new brand new employees at the base rate which they can start them at. But there's always going to be issues with trying to get rid of folks who live and work and raise families here in Missoula. Just because you say, hey, you know, would you be willing to like quit your job for an X amount of sum of money? And then they think it's like, well, I'm going to be working here for maybe 15, 20 years. I'll probably make that more than that in that amount of time. So I don't really see the point in doing that. So the budget for the 2017-2018 school year is built around the current level of faculty, said officials. The goal is to make offers in the next school year and recognize savings in the following school year or the 2019 fiscal year. In the state, it looks like Montana will not be getting that mail-in ballot only election. With the bill that Governor Steve Bullock revived was put into effect this week, only to be put to rest at the Republican majority, who feels as though that this election would benefit Democrats if it was a mail-in only election. Also, many communities from all across the state of Montana, as far as Fort Peck Reservation, came down to protest this mail-in ballot election only. As a way to save money from the last election, which lost money because ballots had to be recalled when Libertarian Mike Fellows died, and they had to replace his name with the other Libertarian Party leader in the state of Montana. Also, Green Party and other small party leaders are suing to get their name on the ballot, which by this time next month will probably not happen, but the lawsuit will probably go into effect for any future recall elections as well. May 25th is the election. Go to MissoulaVotes.com, and if you're not in Missoula or around the area, you can go to your local courthouse to find out more information, but a lot of times the elections office is usually in fairgrounds and other obscure places, in a way, if you really think about it. In national news, healthcare costs have gone up as a reaction to the unknown landscape that is potential end of the Affordable Health Care. Repubicans lost out on repealing the Affordable Care Act, but are trying again, and it does kind of feel as though the healthcare system and insurance are rising to kind of out of fear, because they don't know what's going down, what's going on. Originally, Obamacare was created to encourage young folks to basically get health insurance. So in a way, it would basically be, oh, you know, you pay maybe about $200 a month for your health insurance through your job and all that stuff, and then it would help lower the premiums and the costs for some of the older folks. But it's pretty stagnant, where it says that young people don't have to pay as much, and the older you are, the more you have to pay, which definitely makes sense. But this plan that the that some of them are going to be working on is to waive some of those protections. It will allow the states to choose whether or not they want to do waive certain things, because some states have certain programs. Like in Montana, we have Medicaid, and we voted to expand Medicaid not too long ago. So that's one of the things that some states can choose to do to save some money in terms of healthcare costs. So we'll see how that kind of works out in the next couple weeks or so when the GOP goes back into talking about the healthcare bill. So that basically is happening in your locally news and everything today. I have an art clip for you guys, and when I come back, I'll bring out Darko Butorac to talk about the Rite of Spring being performed by the Missoula Symphony Orchestra. We're back here with Darko Butorac, and he is the conductor of the Missoula Symphony Orchestra. We're glad to have you here.
Great to be here.
And you're here to talk about an upcoming concert next Saturday, and you were talking, you sounded so passionate about this particular music that will be performed next week. So let's talk a little bit about that.
Yes. So this is probably the concert I've been most excited about presenting in my 10 years as music director in Missoula. We're performing two very important pieces. To open the concert, we performed The Four Seasons by Vivaldi, which is probably one of the most popular, maybe the most recorded piece in music history. We have a wonderful violinist, her name is Sandy Cameron. She's young, dynamic, and she'll actually be leading the orchestra. It's a small ensemble, it's about 20 musicians, so I actually step off the podium and she leads the charge, so to speak. Then in the second half is probably the largest orchestral piece we've performed together as an orchestra. It's The Rite of Spring by Stravinsky. And I believe we have about 100 musicians on stage, and it's so tight that we couldn't put risers up. We usually have risers for our woodwind and brass players, and they simply cannot fit on them. So the entire stage is packed with musicians. And here's a piece that actually caused a riot, a proper riot, at its first performance. It's gripping, it's edgy. I like to say it's like heavy metal of 1913. The whole concept of the piece was a ballet that was, as we talked, was meant to be counterculture in every single way, in music, in choreography, in even the costumes and the designs of the set. And so people were just shocked. It was true, the beginning of modernism in the 20th century kind of way that we first knew of.
All right. So where can you tell the folks at home where and when this is happening?
So this is the last weekend of April. It's Saturday, April 29th, Sunday, April 30th. Saturday show is at 7:30 p.m. Sunday is at 3 p.m. Tickets are available on MissoulaSymphony.org, or you can call us at 721-3194. And we also have a pre-concert talk 1 hour before performance, which in this case really is worth coming to, because it's a lot to talk about, a lot of cool background, especially to the Rite of Spring, that I'll share with the audience prior to the concert. So again, MissoulaSymphony.org is probably the best place to buy tickets.
Great. So you were talking a little bit about how this original performance, you kind of feel like it's like the heavy metal of concerts.
Sure. You know, I'll just give you one simple note. Is Stravinsky wrote this in Switzerland on a beautiful lake, kind of like, imagine you go to Flathead and you write a symphony. It's this beautiful nature, and he writes a piece that's so edgy that his landlady like wants to kick him out because it's so loud and rambunctious and dissonant and just crazy. In fact, when he was writing it, he didn't know how to notate some of the rhythms he was hearing in his head. It's not traditional. It's not like um-chak kind of music. It's all like it's like it's jumping all over the place. And so as a result, there's like 8 editions of this piece that he produced in his life, trying to refine what he was actually hearing. So yeah, really the most revolutionary piece of music of the 20th century,
yeah.
Period.
And you also said that with the Rite of Spring, it's R-I-T-E of Spring.
Correct.
And the meaning behind this is basically, could you tell us a little bit more about the meaning?
Yeah, so the story of the ballet, the concept of the ballet is that it describes an ancient pagan ritual in prehistoric Russia. And the idea is that a girl is selected from the village, she volunteers, and she dances herself to death as a way for spring to come again and life is renewed and life can go on. So that was the concept. And even the dancing itself, the way it was designed, was meant to be controversial. So.
Right.
People went to see girls in tutus and in silk and said they saw dancers in wool costumes that danced very close to the ground. So if we think of like kind of modern contemporary dance, the first time that ever happened was also with the Rite of Spring.
Wow.
Most revolutionary artistic statement of the 20th century.
Yeah. Because with music and orchestra music, and then you have ballet. I mean, ballet was ballet. Everyone, like, when you think of ballet, you know what ballet is. But this is one of those things that was just like, oh, wait, that's not ballet.
Correct.
Not my ballet, that
kind of
thing.
Exactly. That was exactly the controversy. And that's, you know, as soon as the ballet started, people started yelling, you know, people who were, I guess, it's like, this is not music, this is not ballet. And the other people are, of course it's ballet, it is music. And, yeah, apparently even, like, dual invitations were exchanged at the premiere.
Wow.
Yeah. People were passionate about the art.
So this big passion project, music that you're going to be performing next week, could you tell us once again when and where it's going to happen?
So Saturday night, 7:30 p.m. at Denison Theater on University of Montana campus. Sunday performance, 3 p.m. Tickets available at MissoulaSymphony.org.
All right. Well, thanks for joining me.
Thank you very much.
And you guys should check it out. Missoula Symphony is wonderful. A lot of wonderful performances. And this one is sure to be just as wonderful, if not more so.
More so, definitely. Sweet.
Hey guys, Brit Garner is here, and she's here to talk about March for Science. So you've been on my show 3 different times, and you talked about 3 different things, but this one is in correlation with your last interview, which is about science, and this one is also about science.
Indeed, because science is totally awesome, right? Right. So we are having a March for Science tomorrow, and it is not just we. It's actually international, happening in Washington, D.C. is where the main one is planned, but there's more than 500 marches happening internationally on Saturday as well, and Missoula is one of the towns that is going to have one of these marches.
And what can people expect? Where do people meet to be a part of this march?
Yeah, so we are going to be starting off with a rally at Karis Park at 1 p.m. tomorrow on Saturday, and that's around the amphitheater, and we're going to have a bunch of scientists and different speakers from the community read thank you letters to scientists and kind of just all get pumped up and then start the actual march, the walk, around 2 p.m.
Right, and what is the trail of the march?
The March Trail. Yes, so from Karis Park, we're going to go along that north riverfront path, that trail, and then go across the Orange Street Bridge, come down off the Kim Williams Trail, and then end right back going to the loop over the Higgins Street Bridge to Karis Park. However, people are welcome to get off at any point, and we're going to have people along the way to help those who might need assistance onto the bridge, off of the bridge, etc.
Right. I'm gonna kind of throw a little quote out there. There's a quote I heard, strangely, from a comedian. I think Ricky Gervais said this, and he said is that if there ever was like a giant reset button, science would always find a way to come back.
Yeah, I think that's because science is simply asking questions, and what's more simple and what's more part of the human condition than being curious and asking questions. So regardless of a reset, I think we'll always be curious and we'll always want to celebrate the unknown and kind of reaching it, especially together.
Yeah, I mean it's so interesting because, you know, like, you have all these interesting facts, and like even like Stephen Hawking hasn't never won a Nobel Prize.
Yeah, which is a crime against humanity. But I mean, you know, Nobel or not Nobel, I mean, there's things happening every day, even on the local level, that are so amazing that might never get rewarded because science kind of isn't about the reward. The reward is the knowledge. So yeah. There are funny discrepancies like that, but I think that he would even probably agree that nothing he's done has been for the prize.
Right, yeah. You do it for the forward of mankind.
Totally.
A Nobel Prize is kind of like one of those things that a lot of people just want, but don't know why they want.
Yeah, I think that's actually a really cool way to put it. That's exactly how it is, yeah, where science is really the quest for knowing, whether it's the answer you wanted or not.
I mean, some people, like the knowledge of science is like, it is its own reward. It's like, you know, I don't understand why this particular bowl of water is warmer than the other ones without the one that's direct sunlight. Oh, UV light.
Check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, and sometimes we don't know mechanism. That's the thing about science, is that sometimes we find these unbelievable things, but we don't know why. And that's okay. That's just the next question, right?
So who of the speakers that are going to be speaking at the amphitheater at Karis Park at 1 p.m. tomorrow, April 22nd, are you most excited for?
I'm most excited to read both the letters we have from politicians. So we have letters from Montana State politicians. And also, I'm excited to read the thank you letters. So we've been collecting thank you letters from K-12 students and college students, just saying, you know, thank a scientist, or, you know, why do you think science is awesome? And I am honestly looking forward to those, because I think that is what's most exciting, is to see the range of thoughts and appreciation in our community.
Yeah, the thing that science has always kind of done for me is, like, it always gives you that thought where it's like, huh, I never thought of it that way.
Oh, yeah, totally. It's always good to squash your own status quo. At least that's how I feel. You know, I always, like, I'm like, prove me wrong. Like, that's one of the coolest feelings ever, if you accept it as being awesome.
And science is one of those things that, like can sometimes many people use it as a way to be like, oh, the world's coming to an end, you know, we should not do this, we should not do that. But a lot of times when people come to their the revelation of their own, it's just like they feel better about it for some reason.
Yeah.
It's like an epiphany in a way.
Right. And I think that knowing something, or knowing how something works, is in its own sense peaceful, right? There is a peace there and an understanding that comes from knowing why the things around you are the way they are. There's nothing more stressful than being in a situation where everything's foreign, you don't know how it works, you don't know which way is left or right, and science is the way that we make that situation calmer by explaining the what's and sometimes even the how's.
All right, so once again, where can people find more information and where can people meet up?
Yeah, awesome question. So again, this is happening tomorrow on Saturday the 22nd, and we're going to start off at Karis Park Amphitheater at 1. The march will be at about 2 p.m. You can find more information at the Missoula March for Science event page on Facebook. Or you can certainly reach out to any of those that you've seen posting about it. We're all happy to discuss it.
Well, thanks, Britt.
Thank you so much, and we hope to see all you guys tomorrow. Have a wonderful weekend.
All right. We'll be right back right after this.
Back to Teen Talks. I'm Neil Wells. Today we will be discussing alternative slogans for companies and the horrors of standardized tests. Spooky.
Spooky stuff.
So spooky. So let's start with the slogans. Does anybody have any clever ones?
No.
McDonald's. I'm loving the diabetes.
I love McDonald's. They come in, you know, you go in there and get type 2 diabetes, and then they get pushed off a wonderful little rainbow by a really scary-looking clown.
Wow.
I mean, that's more of a description rather than a slogan.
It can be used as both at this point.
We'll workshop it.
Mas, bro.
No. Taco Bell, the ultimate stoner joint.
That's White Castle.
White Castle, the ultimate stoner joint.
I don't even know the White Castle
food. I don't even know that
slogan, though.
You know, I've never had White Castle.
Me neither.
I don't even know what that is.
It's a burger place.
Yeah,
it's Chicago, right? Or is it all over the place?
It's all over the place. Montana just doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Yep. Carl's Jr. and they just have supermodels. They don't have really have a slogan.
Oh yeah, they do.
Let's just put a bunch of supermodels.
Their slogan
on
is only
good.
Their slogan is only at Carl's Jr.
Carl's Jr. What happened to Carl's Sr.? Yeah.
He's dead.
I'm trying to think of some catchphrases.
Are your nuggets soggy? It's probably because we didn't make them with love.
Okay. I've got a temporary slogan for McDonald's. We got the Szechuan sauce.
Oh my god. Papa John's better pizza.
Better pizza.
Eat our pizza. Eat our pizza.
Why isn't anyone eating our pizza?
Why isn't anyone eating the pizza?
We need the business.
Why isn't anyone?
We use better ingredients, damn it.
We have a football person sponsoring us.
Look at Peyton Manning. Look at his Peyton Manning.
He hates our pizza, but he still eats it.
He's contractually obligated. Okay. Well, what about Wendy's?
What is the Wendy's slogan again? I forget.
The Wendy's, it's
always fresh, never frozen.
Always frozen, never fresh. Obviously.
You like cows? Because this is not what this is. We grill our salads.
Also, Wendy's old-fashioned hamburgers.
Yeah, old-fashioned hamburgers.
Old-fashioned hamburgers.
I don't think that's their slogan.
No, I guess it isn't.
Quality
Wendy's,
is our recipe.
We put a skew.
Oh, yeah.
Quality is our recipe. Quality.
Come up with some.
Quantity.
Quantity is our recipe.
When, no,
you know
what?
How many cows are in one Wendy's burger?
You know what's
me
really
neither,
funny?
But it's got to be a lot.
It's more than one, and that's concerning.
You know what's really funny, though? You know what's really funny, though? I like how they put a skinny girl on the billboard, and then the actual Wendy's that the place was named after is, like, really overweight. It's like, what are you trying to tell me?
Wait. What's the Burger King slogan?
I was just about to ask that.
I never go there.
Jack in a Box.
Oh, that.
Oh,
like,
Burger King.
I used to eat there all the time.
I think it's like grilled. What's the Burger King? Don't tell me. I know it. I think it's like flame grilling burgers since 1954, isn't it?
That's just their promo for showing you how long they've been around.
Yeah. Okay. Wait. Fuddruckers, because we're too lazy to assemble your burger for you.
Oh, I have a good one, and I'll explain it.
That was good.
Man, Notorious P.I.G. better get here quick.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Notorious P.I.G. is pretty good, though.
Yeah. Fuddruckers, giving you food poisoning every night.
Wait, what's that? Wait, where did that kid go where he got, what's it called? It's called when you eat food, it's like a bad thing, because it's like not cooked all the way.
Food poisoning?
No, it's actually a special name.
Salmonella?
No.
It's not.
E. coli?
E. coli, yeah.
I got it first. I got it first, Liam.
It's like a bacteria.
It's not a competition, but I got it first.
I'm in the one in Jensen's class.
Yeah.
Serving E. coli since, I don't know, I don't remember where that kid got that.
You know what Chipotle's slogan should be? Can we make our burritos and eat bigger?
Chipotle, we're not getting free guac.
Chipotle, we put a whole cow in there.
Chipotle.
We're just a bad version of Cafe Rio.
Chipotle, Cafe Rio
Dairy
is
Queen.
Not entirely great.
Dairy Queen. Hot dogs count as dairy, right?
Dairy
All right.
Hot dogs are
so
great.
We're running out of time, so we're just going to quickly shift over to the horrors of standardized testing.
Okay.
This is how you get past.
You've done standardized testing before.
Yeah. Skip that
but
day.
She did today.
Yeah. So, what are your opinions on standardized testing?
Okay, usually if I don't know what I'm studying or what I'm doing in the test, I just make a pattern. A, B, B, C, D. A, A, B, B, C, D. 20% of the time, it's correct.
Just like you see this guy Owen.
Or you can just mark
the
same.
The time.
I'm totally joking. I just usually just wing it, because that's what you do on tests.
So, any other prominent thoughts?
Your hair would look really weird.
I had like a big test today.
The big test? Yeah. You did the ACT.
I did do the ACT.
How did you feel about the ACT?
How was hell?
I feel like
I... see the Satan down there?
No, but my math sucked. I don't think my...
Is it stereotypical if I actually say that I'm good at math?
Yes.
I'm not bad at math.
He's good at math.
Humble brag time.
Quit breaking. You're never getting married now. No, continue.
I don't think my science was any better, but I think my reading and writing in English I'm kind of confident about that. And I'm kind of nervous about it, too, because I have scores that I'm going to send to four different colleges.
Wait, really quick, before we leave, Liam hasn't really talked at all.
Yeah, Liam, please speak.
Yeah.
We need one new catchphrase, though, from before, because he didn't really have any ideas that I heard.
Hot seat, peer pressure.
ACTs, they're standardly delicious.
Okay, it's a test.
Okay, let the man speak.
No!
Quick, we've only got a minute.
Okay, fine. Well, I guess that's it. This is
I guess what? That's it.
Wait,
I'm the allows. This has been Teen Talks.
This is now a thing. Holy crap.
'Hey guys, let's talk about some movies that are coming out this weekend. Yes, there are movies coming out this weekend, and let's kick it off with, not that, but this. From the actress from all those Netflix Marvel TV shows, Rosario Dawson comes unforgettable. Following the recent cancellation of her show, Katherine Heigl must deal with the fact that her husband has moved on and married another woman. What Miss Heigl does is go cray-cray and try to destroy Rosario Dawson's character psychologically, verbally, and eventually physically until something like, good woman triumphs or the psycho wins and bittersweet victory. But one thing is for sure that this is a thriller, and that will always end with an eye-popping ending. You know those movies where, like the person's dead and they're just like, they're zooming in closer and closer? And then there's like, it's like, to be continued, or is it, or the end, or to be continued, the end. Anyways, moving on. Free Fire is another movie that comes down the pipe that is super violent and lets the movie make fun of itself for being violent. This one's called Free Fire. It's from actors you may recognize from other movies. The trailer shows you only a little bit, basically, because they want to show you too much, because there are going to be a lot of people who die in this movie. That's kind of like the thing. But don't expect a lot. Expect maybe an indie standoff kind of like film that will tickle your culture or lack of culture bone. Moving on. The Promise, yes, here we have a movie with so many good actors, what could possibly go wrong? Well, that seems wrong as well. It's the end of the Ottoman Empire, and only a plucky Associated Press member can get all the facts to tell a story about a war that will tear apart a country. But with this, we'll take a second fiddle to a Lifetime original movie with a bigger budget about two people who have been in love with each other since they've laid eyes on each other. But for a girl, she is married to the Associated Press guy, whose story means more to him than this woman. I suppose the other guy has to make a promise to the woman, otherwise this title the title of this movie wouldn't make sense. This segment. Moving on, I got another movie that I took from the public domain world, plucked it, removed the audio, and inserted some of my own audio on there as well. And it's called The Flying... Ooh, that's the wrong button. That's what I wanted to do. It's called The Flying Deuces. I don't want to sing that song. Okay, so without further ado, here's Flying Deuces. And when I come back, I'm going to talk about all the things that are happening in your city, which includes the Fort Missoula Regional Park.
All right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Hey, do you remember where we're supposed to go?
Yes, I do. I know exactly where to go.
Huh? What's that?
Top Gun. Listen to Top Gun, the music, yeah. Top Gun. Listen to Top Gun, the music, yeah.
Well, that was a total waste of time.
I like Top Gun. I think it's the best movie, hands down.
Well, don't stop your feet. I'm only saying it's not that great of a movie. Let's go.
I thought I put the cigar out.
Darling, I've missed you so much.
You taste like asparagus. I love asparagus.
For you, dear, asparagus forever and ever and ever.
As I was saying before...
Way! Excuse me, lady traveling alone! I was hoping you could answer some questions!
Oh my god!
Oh, could it be? You? Oh, let me shake your hand! Let me just sing to the world!
Excuse me!
Sing!
Excuse me, we got no time to reminisce with some ladies!
That's Balderdash! I love this lady! I'm gonna give her a kiss!
Friend zone, you have to realize...
Whoa, could you excuse us for a second?
I'm willing to see where this is going. Yeah. Oh, okay, I'm leaving.
The wheel's supposed to be on this side. Huh?
Now where are we? Friend zone! I'm gonna steal a kiss. Give me another one!
Que pasa? I can't wait to tell him to go get her the room. You get your hands off of her! I love her very much. Sick and tired of your Adonis types.
Ain't I a stinker? Huh? Did you just call me an Adonis?
Indeed I did. Come with me.
Oh, please. Just leave him alone.
I will leave him alone as soon as he answers a few questions.
I guess the script tells me to storm off.
Now you listen here, you very attractive big man. Good-looking people shouldn't just go around kissing other people. It's not nice. You should be ashamed of yourself. What do you have to say for yourself? Huh? Huh? Well, what do you say? What do you gotta say? What do you have to say for yourself?
What's the meaning of this? Well, let me tell you this. He's not as good-looking as he says he is. Do you see me trying to vouch for you?
Appreciate it.
Now, skinny up. You're quite a mess right there, son. Hey, Soulja Boy. Do you want to listen to Soulja Boy? We got it queued up. Isn't that right?
Oh, let's crank it.
Do you guys mind if I bring a few friends? We're gonna need some pizza rolls, hey?
Not to be a party pooper, but we just don't have the space.
Hmm, you don't have the space, do ya? Maybe if each of us brought something.
I don't know.
Enough! Take them away! We're gonna have a party at your place whether you like it or not. Now march! Are you ready, soldiers? Left, right,
left, right, left, right, left, 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 right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right.
Hey guys, welcome back. Let's talk about some city council stuff. So, Neil Miner, he talked with the city council during Parks and Conservation about the Fort Missoula Regional Park. He talked about how phase one is being complete and how the Fort Missoula is about ready to be launched on April 29th. I'll talk a little bit more about that after we talk about what's happening currently with the Fort Missoula Regional Park. Here is Neil Miner. He is the project manager of the Fort Missoula Regional Park, and he talks about the Fort Missoula Regional Park.
We had snow in the field, and so we didn't have any reservations really. It's a synthetic turf field. We use chrome rubber.
Wait, hold on a second. I think I got the timing all wrong right there. Oh, my bad. I was 2 minutes ahead of myself. So let me just cue it up just a little bit. It won't take me too long. Maybe it'll take me longer. Okay, so here it is. Here's the actual quote. Bear with me.
The plaza, the whole playground here, the synthetic turf field, and then this is the 9 multi-purpose rectangle sports fields. That's another view with the kind of, it looks like we were set up for lacrosse. This was 2 weeks ago, I think. So you can see some of these areas have been sodded already. This is a 15-acre open space parcel. We're actually working with the tribe to relocate some bitterroot flowers out here. This was one of their gathering spots. So we've been harvesting seeds to areas as close as we can to this, because apparently some of the elder tribesmen or elders can actually determine where the bitters came from by the taste and how bitter they are. And the ones in that area were some of the best ones in the valley. Apparently where Shopko was had the best ones, but.
And here's another interesting fact is that Shopko was one of those places that basically kind of started the surgence of the Reserve Street. So basically Shopko was there first, and then a whole bunch of other businesses started popping up and around there. And the old historic, military museum used to be where the Goodwill is now. I swear, because when I was a kid, I used to see that tank that's in front of the military museum at Fort Missoula. Now, back then, it was in front of just off of Reserve Street. And Fort Missoula kind of was one of those interesting things, because I went on a bus tour the other night with the Office of Neighborhoods, Jane Kelly and all those guys, and they were talking about a little history of Fort Missoula, and I thought it was really interesting. So that was just a little side note. I'm going to get back on track. In spring 2018, Fort Missoula Regional Park Phase 2 will be complete with all sorts of fun stuff that Neil Miner will continue right here.
We have the 5-plex area with the concession building in the inside, and then a little 2-plex, pickleball courts, the headquarters building, so we have a couple offices in there for our rec staff, and then our maintenance. There's a maintenance bay, and there's a room similar to what we have over at Parks, the headwaters room, so it's kind of a reservable indoor kind of room available for the user groups, and there's a plaza right outside there, and then the dog park, and then where my mouse is, dog park, and then there's an inclusive all abilities playground, similar to what we have at McCormick Park as well, the Silver Summit, fully poured in place. Silver Summit's kind of the 2 to 5 age group, or a little more. This is kind of the 5 to 12 age group, so a little older age range. Should be pretty neat playground. And then we actually worked with the teens and I guess tweens at Big Sky, and then at CS Porter, on this kind of, we kept calling it the teen area, and I think we call it the commons. I think some of the stuff got changed names, and then when you're working on a project for a while, it's on a working name, it's hard to switch your mindset.
All right, so they were talking, he talked a little bit more about some of the opportunities they have for the phase two of construction in terms of they got some input from some teens and some young kids from CS Porter. They talked about maybe having a kind of like a natural hill so they can have like performance and stuff. So, because CS Porter kids, a lot of them who gave suggestions were in drama, and they wanted to kind of perform and have a way to perform for each other at the park. So I think that would be really cool. Maybe like a mini amphitheater, that kind of thing. So this last quote from the Parks and Conservation is from Ruth Swaney, and Neil Miner also responds to talk about some of the fields, which will have electronic – I mean, like the plastic field, the turf field that has an electronic scoreboard and electronic horns for like, you know, like when it goes, woo, okay, game's over or quarter's over, that kind of thing. I don't know why I had to make that sound for you. I think you guys kind of pretty much got it. But here is Ruth Swaney.
So it's cool to see the presentation and hear some of the background. And prior to the game, the president of his club made sure to email all of the family and tell them make sure and park in the right spaces, and we want to be welcomed back to use the space. And so she was very conscientious about making sure we parked where we needed to be. And there was a lot of excitement for when the lights will be on and then when we can use the scoreboard. So there's definitely enthusiasm for the space. And I really thought it was beautiful and appreciated.
The scoreboard is working now.
Well, now.
as of 2 days ago. And the horn on the scoreboard as of yesterday is working. So there was one connection they had yet to hook up. And
well, that day it rained, and so it was really slick. And so the boys would just try to stop, and they would be sliding. But it was very beautiful. Thank you.
And then there's more bleachers out there than I think you guys had. And there's a shade shelter out there that we have to get the fabric up. We took it down during the winter, and so there's a nice little shade shelter. All the user groups have been really good on following the rules that we kind of, not only us, but the contractor, since it's kind of an open construction site.
All right, so they'll be hosting a press release day for the press on Monday. I have RSVP'd for that, so I'm going to get a nice little pre-opening tour of the Fort Missoula Regional Park, which I will show you on Wednesday's show, of a nice little short package, but of course it will be on MCAT beforehand, and you can find that at MCAT.org. Moving on, we got some land use and planning. I have only one coach from two different meetings, so I'm going to keep it nice and short for the last two parts of City Council report. At the request of the City Council, the Developmental Services Planning staff has drafted an amendment to the administration chapter addressing Historic Preservation Commission membership and voting sections of Title 20 and Title 20 Missoula City Zoning Ordinance. The primary purpose of updating this ordinance is to simplify membership requirements, make the commission smaller and optimum for efficiency, and to add more flexibility in how members are appointed. Gwen Jones, she talks about this from talking with current members of the Historic Preservations and what they hope that future members will be. I'll just shut up, and here's Gwen Jones.
Revised it so that I think it's in a good place now. Having the categories of preservation law and historic preservation amongst the expertises listed opens some good doors, I think. But what came out of our conversations was the issue of to what degree the HPC will have a quasi-judicial role is something that will need to be discussed, and that started to overlap into some of these requirements. So we just decided to simplify it down, put off until the cleanup on the ordinance that issue of if the HPC wants to request outside expertise or help on a matter, because it kind of dips into the quasi-judicial issue. So that's further on down the road, and this is a pretty simplified membership ordinance at this point, and I think we're ready to have a public hearing on it.
All right, so the public hearing will take place on May 15th. You guys can give your comments and how you feel about the new kind of ordinance and amendments to the Historic Preservation Commission on May 15th, which is going to be a regular city council meeting on a Monday night at starting at 7 p.m. The details of this change are available on SIRE, which is the online database for all those meetings from the city's website, ci.missoula.mt.us. Moving on, we have a committee of the whole meeting, which Tasha Jones, she's the lawyer that represented Missoula during the water condemnation hearing. She's been with us from the very beginning and throughout this whole entire time. And she's from Great Falls, and she's just a wonderful lawyer. I just got to say it. So Tasha Jones, she talks about the current status of how defendants of Mountain Water are still debating with Missoula's attorneys for legal fees, and also some other issues of people wanting to get paid for some of their work and some of their work that they've been basically working with the city, and also the defendants also trying to get paid through Missoula as well.
I'm going to backtrack just a little bit. The other thing that happened is Judge Karen Townsend issued her final order on attorney's fees. And just to give you a little bit of context there, the defendants wanted us to pay them $8 million, it was $7.9 million to be precise, in attorney's fees. We objected to that. We had a trial on that issue. Judge Townsend issued her ruling, and she just made the final order of $3.9 million, so a 50% reduction in the fees and costs that were claimed by the defendants. That ruling is subject to potential appeal by the defendants in 30 days, or when the final order of condemnation is issued. Last week we filed a response in Judge Halligan's court related to the developer extension agreements. So in Judge Halligan's court, we are trying to figure out the amount of money that needs to be set aside out of the condemnation proceeds to handle the developers. We are in opposition with Mountain Water on that. And right now, the primary area of dispute is whether Mountain Water has to pay the unnamed parties. So I think probably many of you have been approached by developers who have not appeared in Halligan's case, but they have a contract. And they're wondering, do I get paid too? I want to get paid too. There are hundreds of folks in our community like that, about 200. And the total amount that's owed to them is $6.6 million. We have filed a motion before Judge Halligan stating that she needs to join those unnamed parties to that lawsuit or pledge to make sure they're taken care of, but they need to be paid too.
All right, so that was kind of like the update on basically some of the smaller moving parts, but they all come up to a lump sum of that $6+ million fee as well. So that's basically the tip of the iceberg from the Committee of the Whole. There's a whole bunch of meetings you guys can go to by logging on to ci.missoula.mt.us. It's such a nice website. It's where I get all my information about City Council, and it really helps because if I show you the meeting itself, basically I click on your government and I go to Agenda Webcast Minutes, and brings me to this site. And it gives you links to all the meetings. Future meetings have agendas, and past meetings have MP4 minutes. And you just click on the agenda, and it brings you to one of these pages with a video of which I just showed you. And the really cool thing is if you click on any of these hyperlinks that are on the left side of the agenda, the video automatically goes to that topic, which is wonderful, because sometimes when I'm researching in a meeting, I'm like, I don't need to really do the consent agenda, because it's basically them reading off the consent agenda and then saying, do you approve, yay, nay, and then they spend about like 15 minutes on that. So basically it helps me centralize on what is really important about the meeting. But you guys can go on ci.missoula.mt.us to watch the whole meetings and then some Because there's so much within the city and the city of Missoula. They're very transparent about information, so you guys can see past meetings and future meetings by logging onto that website, ci.missoula.mt.us. I got a Flagship Friday video of the week for you right now, and when I come back, I'm going to talk about some events that are happening here in and around Missoula. Briefly, but I'm going to start with a Flagship Friday video being featured from Lowell Elementary School, one of my newest schools that I do Tuesday afternoons.
Time to assassinate.
Die today.
I'm the warrior woman of Shakanara.
I am the druid of the moon.
Ha! I found that funny.
Do you insult my religion? My way of life?
You forgot that you don't have your powers now because the moon's not out.
Well, that sucks. I should have planned ahead of time.
What's going on?
Well, this moon, Drew, just saved your life.
Whoa, can you be my master?
I'm not really open for students right now. You can call my secretary or send a carrier pigeon or whatever you want. Call me on the phone.
Okay.
Hey, what are you doing? Call my secretary or something. Don't come straight to
hey,
me.
Hey, you three, get over here.
Wait. Haven't I seen you before, or have I been told a story about you?
Let me think. I didn't even...
Oh yeah, you're the sorcerer dude that was frozen 1,000 years ago, and now he's back.
I didn't know a wizard existed.
Wizard? No such thing. I came here because of the prophecy.
The prophecy?
Yes, the prophecy. Prophecy? What is the prophecy?
The prophecy?
The prophecy says that a warrior woman, an assassin, and a druid will come together to destroy the smoke which lives over your mountain. You must defeat that smoke monster before it destroys us. Somehow.
I'm just a regular human. I can't fight.
I need to get to distract it while I conjure up a spell. How can we fight something that I can't even touch?
Thank you.
We did it.
We can't defeat it. We can only subdue it for now.
I'm hurt.
The moon!
I can heal you. We'll never forget you. Are you sure that that helped?
I don't know. It's my first time. If he dies, he's dead. I can't revive. Oh, yeah, I can revive him.
I feel much better, actually.
Well, off to the next fight.
Yeah! Okay, see ya.
Yeah.
All right, so that was Smoke Monster, Flagship Friday. As you can tell, that was the uncut version of the Lost season finale, series finale. I don't have much time left. Let's talk about some of the things that are happening. There's the Earth Day Republic Services landfill. The Republic Service, you know, your garbage man, is going to be doing a Earth Day thing, cleanup at the Earth Day Community Appreciation at the landfill. Complimentary food is available from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., and it's free tree sapling for the first 100 visitors. Eagle Silent Auction and Dinner, Missoula Fraternal Order of the Eagles 32 is raising money for a pair of local charities with its 12th annual Hands Across the Border Silent Auction. And it's happening from 4 to 7 at the Missoula Eagles Airy, located at 2420 South Avenue West, and starts at 4 p.m. Missoula Art Park Dedication is happening today at 4 o'clock, 4:30-ish p.m. until about 7. You guys can go check out the new art park. It's going to be a grand opening, and Mayor John Ng is going to christen the new toilet, the new public toilet that's at the art park. So it should be a grand old time. You guys should totally check it out. I have about 2 minutes left. So this is the 9th annual Superfund run. Celebrate Earth Day with the trails to in Bonner, a beautiful Friday night. It's going to be like starting at 6 p.m. They're going to be starting at the Our Savior's Lutheran Church. They're going to meet up there. It's Superfund site because the Bonner Dam is a Superfund site. And there will be a race on that. But, of course, there's a whole bunch of things happening this weekend on Saturday. I can't really get through them all. There's Appleseed Rifle Shoot starting at Deer Creek Rifle Range at 8 a.m. It's going to be guns, shooting, marksmanship. And if you don't have a gun, they will have 22 rifles available for you guys. Run for the Trees are starting at 8 a.m. in McCormick Park. You get a Run for the Trees. You can register today anytime. You go to 721 Park to register. Big Sky High School Gym is doing a indoor bocce ball tournament. So you guys can check that out. It's $10 per player. Each player, 4 games, win or lose. You can pick a cool name for your team. It's a 32-team limit, and you can sign up your team today. Montana Wilderness Quilt Show is happening at will be happening tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. I have about a minute left. You got Earth Day Exploration in Arts and Science starting at the Missoula Art Museum at 9:30 a.m. Clark Fork River Cleanup. They do their annual cleanup. Last year they had over 700 people help clean up Clark Fork River, and it's going to be great. They clean up 4,000 pounds of trash and 651 pounds of recyclables from 15 miles of the river. So Clark Fork is not as clean as you may look around and be like, huh, it doesn't look that bad, but it is that bad. So you guys, if you want to be involved, be part of the Clark Fork River cleanup, 10 a.m. starting at Karis Park. But also Karis Park is having Earth Day celebration. Brit Garner was on the show. I want to thank her for coming on. Darko Butorac will be doing a passion project of his next week for the symphony, and you guys can totally check that out. Go into MissoulaSymphony.org. That's about it for my morning show. I wish I could have showed you some of the new program that would be airing on MCAT, but I will post that online later, so you guys can check that out much later. So thanks for joining me, and for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ramph.